I am so excited to be joined by Julie Rines, the head of our Youth Services Department here at the library, to talk about what we have going on for children here at the library this summer. Julie, thanks for joining me today.
Good.
How are you? You're good?
Good, yes.
Nice. It is, we're already off to a rip-roaring start, and July is just packed full of stuff for people to enjoy, with, you know, for people with kids and kids with their families.
Yes, we do. So. We have all kinds of programs going on this summer, but first I want to talk about our summer reading challenge.
All right.
We've got a theme this summer of space, a universe of stories. So what we're doing is we're having the kids sign up on our Beanstack software to do the summer reading program. They can also get a paper one if they want. They can just do it online, or they can do it with the paper as well. And as you complete an activity, you'll get a sticker to add
stickers.
To your chart.
So cool.
So even though they're online, sometimes especially the younger kids like to have the stickers to add to the paper chart. So that's fine. They can do it both ways. That's great. And
I like stickers too.
Some of the things will be to read particular types of books, and some of the things will be activities like coming to a program. So
Nice. They
can do all of that. And if they complete 10 of our space missions by August 21st, they will get a medal at the end of the summer.
All right.
But we have to have a head count of who has finished by August 21st so we can order enough medals.
Fair enough.
Certainly would not want to run out of medals.
No. And we're going to be giving out the medals.
The medal ceremony will be on Friday, August 30th at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Okay. And if for some reason you're going to be traveling or something on the 30th?
You can pick your medal up after that.
Nice.
Yep.
Good. So if you're in space, if you've made a trip to the asteroid belt, you can come back and get
it. And get it later, yep. And
that's
another reason why it's great to be able to do this online is because even if you're leaving town to go visit family or go on vacation,
right. You
can keep recording your books and stuff that you've been reading.
And you don't have to keep track of another piece of paper, you can just do it on your phone.
Do it right on your phone and you're good to go.
And if you bring your phone and show, can you still get the stickers?
Yes, yep.
Nice.
Come in, show us your phone which ones you've done, and we'll give you the right stickers. And
that's
you can
great.
Add them on.
Very cool.
So great.
How fun.
Great.
Why is it important that people do this over the summer?
Well, summer reading is important especially for the younger children who are just learning how to read, because they lose their reading skills, their fluency and their vocabulary and remembering how to sound out words and all those early literacy skills. So if they continue to read through the summer, they will keep that all up and they will start back to school in September well ahead of the game. And the teachers like it too, because then they don't have to refresh all of those skills all over again. So
it's so much more interesting when you can learn new skills.
True, so. It is. And like I said, with the ours, we give very broad. The suggestion might be read a nonfiction book, so you can pick whatever topic interests you,
right. Which
is a big important thing in the summer, I think, with kids reading.
You should spend your time in the summer reading stuff that you want to read.
Right, stuff that interests you.
Yeah.
So, and you can certainly read more than the 20 circles we have on here. You can just keep reading and adding things to your chart online. So,
and you can read things that we have available. You can read things from your personal collection.
Right. Yep.
As long as you're reading, we're just happy that you're engaging.
Yep. And you can read things from our digital collection, audiobooks, digital ebooks.
So listening to a book counts too.
Listening to a book counts too. That's actually one of our circles on there.
All right. Good.
And of course, for the little ones who don't read at all, being read aloud too.
That counts,
too. So that's great.
Awesome. So can you do this and the 1,000 books before kindergarten? Or
yes,
is this
actually you can. If you are not in kindergarten yet, when you go on to the Beanstack program to sign up for summer reading, it will give you the option of both programs. And as you scan the barcodes on your books to log them, it should record them in both places
nice.
At the same time.
That's pretty slick.
So that's pretty good. That's great help for parents, especially the read again button for when you read the same book 10 times in a row.
That is because it can be a favorite and you can keep going back.
That's
time
true.
After time.
Yep.
What ages is this for? I know I talked to Carrie, and the teen program is for people entering 7th through 12th grade.
So the children's program is 0 to 12.
0 to 12.
0
so
to 12.
So it is by age.
We do it by age.
Okay. But they do it by
because we don't. Some of our little guys don't have a grade yet.
Sure,
and
makes sense.
Then with the teens, Carrie goes over to the grade levels. And
if you're entering 7th grade, but you're 12, you can kind of decide which one
you
want to
be. You can decide where
you
want to go, yeah.
You can get some stickers and maybe hang out with Carrie, too.
You can come to both programs. You can
there
come
you go.
Make oh, ice cream with us and necklaces or whatever with Carrie.
Nice.
So
that's cool. So what kind of programs are happening this summer? You have something like every day?
We do.
Just about?
Every day, Monday through Friday, there's at least one activity happening for the entire 2 months of the summer.
You all are going to sleep well. Jeez, that's a lot of work.
No one is going to be bored in Quincy, and if they are, it's not my fault.
They're not going to the library, clearly.
That's true. They wouldn't be coming here if they're bored. So some of the things that we're doing, we have a set of library quests.
Yep.
Now, a quest is a sort of a treasure hunt inside the library.
Okay.
So at the main library children's room, the North Quincy branch, and the Wollaston branch, you can pick up the quest, and it's a clue. It might say, look at the sign behind the children's desk, and clue number one is the third letter of the first word.
Okay.
And so you're using the puzzle to spell out a phrase.
Mm-hmm.
So there are different quests in different places. So if you like them, go visit every place and you can do a different quest. And those you can do whenever you stop by the library. But we also have a number of programs that are happening every week this summer. At the North Quincy branch on Monday afternoons, there'll be a movie every week.
Okay.
And they'll be starting... the first couple of movies are Ralph Breaks the Internet on July 1st, the Lego Movie July 2nd, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse on July 15th, Sherlock Gnomes on July 22nd, and Freaky Friday on the 29th of July.
Some fun picks.
So
there.
They've got some fun movies that they'll do each week. And also on Monday afternoons here at the main library, we'll be doing a story craft. So that's at 2:30. Story craft is there'll be one story. So it's not a full-on story time,
mm-hmm.
but it'll be one story. I think all of them are space-themed.
Okay.
And then there'll be a craft that accompanies the story. So you might read a story about a rocket to the moon, and then the craft would be making a rocket.
Cool.
So
or moon, perhaps.
Or perhaps the moon. I don't know. So those are Mondays, July and August. In July, we have a special program, the Storytelling at the Wollaston Breach Tot Lot.
Now, that can be popular, I understand.
It's very popular. And just for a bit of explanation for people, this park seems to go by a multitude of different names.
Okay.
It is the park on the corner of Sachem Street, right next to the Clam Box.
I was going
to
say, there's a couple the Clam of Box Park.
Right, there's a couple of parks along the beach, and that's the park that we do the story times at.
All right.
That's at 10:30 on the Tuesday mornings in July.
Okay.
Now, if it rains, and we've had an awful lot of rain so
that
far this
happen.
Year, we will move the story time to the main library.
So the main library,
yes,
okay.
So the story time will happen. We'll just move indoors because who wants to sit?
And if it looks like it may rain, where do people find out
what's happening? Check the library's website, and the calendar will say that we've moved indoors.
Okay, and we'll update that as soon as we open by 9 o'clock.
Right, as soon as we make the decision, you know, if it's raining Monday night, I'll automatically update it. But if it's just iffy on Tuesday morning, we'll probably make the decision then.
That's fair enough.
So, and then also on Tuesdays in the afternoon, for all the whole summer at the Adam Shore branch, between 2 and 4, you can drop in and make a spacecraft.
Cool.
So each week we'll have a different craft. They all have space themes. Ms. Laurie has been cutting out moons and rockets and stars and astronauts and I don't know what all else to get ready for all of these crafts. So
some serious adventuring happening there.
Yes, so there'll be some great things going on there. On Wednesdays, in the afternoon from 2 to 4 at the Wollaston Branch Library, Miss Amanda will be doing Lego challenges. So the Legos will be out. You can do free build if you want, but each week she will have a challenge. So maybe one of the challenges might be to build the tallest structure that you can, or maybe make a moon buggy or something like that.
Okay.
So you can do either free challenge or... do the challenge or a free build.
Great.
And also, again, on Wednesday nights, we have our pajama story time at the main library.
That's continuing over the summer.
That's continuing over the summer. That's one of the most popular story times that we do. And since it's for a family audience, it's the best one for us to do over the summer because people, you have the whole family together. You can't leave the 3-year-old home to bring the 1-year-old to a story time.
Of course.
So. That lets everybody.
And it's called Pajama Storytime because everybody comes in their pajamas.
They can if they want. It starts at 6:30 on Wednesday evenings. Okay. And some parents who know that their kids will like get sleepy on the car ride home like to already have them in their pajamas, and that's fine.
I assume blankets and teddy bears are fine too?
Certainly. Nice. Get as cozy as you want.
Great.
So, and then our Thursday weekly programs are Liberated Crafts at North Quincy. Now, Miss Kathy has decided to call these Liberated Crafts because instead of having a particular project for the week, she's got a theme. So, starting on that program starts on July 11th because, of course, the 4th of July is a Thursday this year, so we're no program that week.
We will be celebrating on the 4th.
We will. Right,
as everybody else hopefully is too.
Right. So,
so what is a liberated craft?
So she has a theme for the week. So on July 11th, the theme is animal visors. So she will have the visor template and all kinds of different ears and eyes and noses and mouths, and you can make a bear if you want, or a kangaroo or a rabbit or whatever kind of animal.
Or a bear.
You could make your own new version of a platypus, whatever you want to try. So those are great. So there'll be different ones. Like there'll be a week where there's all different supplies to make a wreath or stick puppets or door hangers, all kinds of different things. So those should be lots of fun. Now on the Fridays, we tend to have a different thing going on each week. Mm-hmm. So on Friday, July 5th, we're going to be doing a messy art project, fireworks painting.
Good thing to do at the library, not at home.
Right. And we are really hoping the weather cooperates and we can do it out on the lawn, so any spilled paint just goes into the grass. But
otherwise, it'll be big tarps, I'm sure.
Yes, we will use big tarps. But the fireworks painting art is kind of neat because we have different ways to paint. You just won't use a brush. You can use a fork and thick paint, or
Pollocking or splatter paint.
You can use really thin paint and a straw to blow it, and all kinds of different ways to make starburst patterns to make your own fireworks pictures on dark paper. So that should be really, really neat. On Friday the 12th, we have one of our long-standing special favorite programs, Bubble Day. On Bubble Day,
that's only happening if it's nice weather.
Yes, that only happens if it's nice weather. If it's raining on the 12th, we have to move it to the 19th.
Okay.
Because that has to be outdoors, because many gallons of soapy water do not belong inside anywhere.
Too slippery on our stone floors.
True. So we actually set this up right outside the children's room because it's perfect space. We've got the benches to put the long tubs out on.
Yeah.
We have all different kinds of bubble blowers. We have some nifty new ones that are three-dimensional, so we can put them in a deep bucket and you can make really weird shapes.
And you can see what happens with the different planes.
Yeah, and you can see what happens
inside.
Like if the different planes, and like if you pop certain panes of
how it
changes. Yeah. Those ones are really neat.
That's cool.
We have been having fun playing.
Good.
On the 19th, even if we've had to move Bubble Day to the 19th in the morning, that afternoon, we have a special science program called Tinker Time.
Tinker Time.
And Tinker Time is sort of a free exploration science program. We're going to explore air and we're going to explore gravity.
Okay.
So we will have things to make ball mazes, ramps, and tubes, and you can see, I don't know, you could try making it go as far as you can, or see how fast you can get them to drop by making them steeper.
Right.
And
see how slow you can get it to go.
You could see how the least amount of slope you can use to get it to keep
it
moving.
To move, right? Yeah.
So we'll have balls and maybe things like Hot Wheels cars or something, just things that will roll through all the ramps and stuff. And then for the air part of that activity, we have different things like fans and hair dryers, and the idea will be to see what things you can make float and whether you can direct the airflow of what you're doing. And sometimes, because I got to play with this one already, something that won't float on its own, you can sometimes change it in some way and make it float.
Ooh, that sounds like that was the
most fun part of playing around with learning how to, what we wanted to have available for tinkering with this. It was neat to throw in some things that you had to change.
Right. That's gonna be cool.
So that was pretty cool. And let's see, that's the 19th, and then on the last Friday of the month, we have Music and Movement with Ruby. Music and Movement with Ruby is a very popular program that we usually do on Saturdays during the school year. This summer, we're doing it on the Friday morning. And we do that in two sessions because
so 10 if and it 10:30, gets like
10:30 and 11.
10:30 and 11.
Because okay. Since it's a Friday morning, we want to make sure we don't hit too much traffic.
That makes sense. So getting away from the rush hour traffic.
Right. Yeah. And we break it up. So if the 10:30 session is too crowded, we will just close the doors and ask you to go read some books or do some of the activities off
stickers,
of your things. Yeah. And then we'll open the doors again at 11 and whoosh the first crew out and put the new crew in.
Fun. I know, those are really fun.
And that same afternoon, Friday the 26th in the afternoon, we have a board game afternoon. So we'll have some familiar games that you might know and a few new ones that Miss Amanda was talking about that I've never even heard of.
She knows all the games,
she does. So she's going to bring in Topiary, Potion Explosion, or Suspend. Now those are three games I have never even heard of, I'll have to see if I can get somebody. I want to do Potion Explosion.
That does sound fun.
I'll have to see if I can get someone to play that with me.
Wonderful. July is going to be busy.
And that's not even everything that's happening in July.
So how do people figure out about the other stuff that's happening?
You can check online on the library's website. Yep. All of this is listed on the library's calendar. Mm-hmm. And if you go to the Children's Summer Reading page, we've also, the calendar has it just by date, but on the Children's Summer Reading page, we've also broken it down by age group.
Nice.
So if you just have preschoolers at your house, you could just look at the preschool section and it would let you know which programs are good. And then we have some programs that are specifically for the older kids. There's a cookie decorating program at Adam Shore. There's a solar system necklace craft going on at Wollaston.
Oh, neat.
So different fun things like that. We'll be doing more science with snap circuits. And the big science thing for this year, because we're doing space, of course, we have the Museum of Science Portable Planetarium coming in. They will be here on July 18th from 10 in the morning till noon. Now, the planetarium itself kind of looks like a silver igloo. Mm-hmm. So space is limited. You can only go in batches of 25 at a time, which is why they're going to be here so long. Mm-hmm. We'll have three different sittings, if you will, literally on the floor.
Okay.
And so you'll go in and you'll learn about the night sky and the different constellations and all that kind of fun stuff. That program is for school-age children because the planetarium is very dark and very crowded.
Preschoolers need to be able to hold your own in that kind of environment.
Yes, preschoolers don't do too well once they get in and realize they can't get out.
Yeah.
So
it's totally safe to reassure all the parents.
Oh, it is. It's perfectly safe. It's just that the little guys get
scary.
It's too close.
Yeah.
They don't particularly like it.
I assume you need to register for that one?
No, actually.
No.
What we're going to do is on that morning, we will hand out a ticket to the first 25 people, and they'll go in, and then we'll give out the next batch. And while you're waiting, we will have some things that you can do, maybe some games and maybe make an astronaut helmet and all kinds of different stuff like that.
Nice.
So there'll be all kinds of fun stuff. I mean, honestly, I would be here all day if I mentioned all of them. But I do want to let people know who already come to our book groups during the year.
Yep.
Our book groups will be continuing through the summer. So if you have a first or second grader, you can check out what the chickadees are reading. Third and fourth graders are our Night Owls book group, and fifth through eighth graders are the Phoenix book group.
Nice.
So all three of those book groups continue through the summer, and you can check in the children's room to see what book is being read.
And I think the Dungeons and Dragons group is also still
Yes, the Dungeons and Dragons group is continuing because I think there might be a mutiny if we stop that over the summer, because that's a very popular program with
that's
the older
great.
Kids.
I'm so glad to have Julie join me, and I hope to see you all at all these great events for kids and their families happening here at the library this summer.